Hey guys, what's up? It's Alex or Nuznuz here, and welcome to my full in-depth Wilderness Slayer guide. This guide is going to be focused towards people wanting to utilize Wilderness Slayer to get a tier 10 emblem as fast as possible and to make as much money as possible. However, I do know that Iron Men do Wilderness Slayer for the tier 87 weapons, and you could utilize this guide as well, although it won't be tailored completely towards Iron Men. So the first thing we're gonna do is get right into talking about what Wilderness Slayer is. So Wilderness Slayer, or Slayer Bounties, are Slayer tasks only available from Mandrith in Edgeville, and they must be completed in the Wilderness. Now the main way to make money with Wilderness Slayer is through upgrading a Bounty Emblem. These emblems are received for free when you complete one Wilderness Slayer task. When held in your inventory, when you're completing Slayer tasks, you gain a potential, which will upgrade your bounty emblems into higher tiers. It requires a total of 112 Wilderness Slayer tasks completed to reach the full potential of a tier 10 emblem. Now, if a player were to die with this emblem, it will downgrade it by one tier, but you will not lose it. So for instance, if you are PK'd with a tier 6 emblem, you will be downgraded to a tier 5, which will lose you 12 Slayer tasks of potential. This guide will try to help you minimize dying and also figure out which are the fastest tasks and also the safest tasks to do in the Wilderness. Now we're going to look at the rewards from Wilderness Slayer. So the main rewards are from the Slayer bounty points that you get from turning in your emblem. You'll get 40,000 Slayer bounty points for turning in a tier 10 emblem, which you can spend at the Slayer bounty reward shop. Now depending on the market price at the time, different items can be worth more to buy than others, but on average you'll probably make around 80 to 100 million GP from Slayer bounty points per tier 10 emblem you have, which is really, really good. Now the main rewards that people buy are the tier 87 wilderness weapons and the ancient warrior upgrade patches. It's also worth noting that when killing any monster in the wilderness, you have access to a special wilderness drop table, which can drop things like the Revenant drop enhancer and the Ancient Warrior equipment patch. Most notably, the money you'll be getting is going to come from the Ancient Warrior equipment patches, which go for around 10 million GP each, and I usually get a few every time I go for a tier 10 emblem, so it adds up nicely and will make you even more profitable. So we're going to start out with the notable items you should use while doing Wilderness Slayer. And firstly, we have probably the most important, which is the Slayer VIP tickets. Now, Slayer VIP tickets are tickets that allow you to choose between two different Slayer tasks when receiving a Slayer task. And since there are only 15 Wilderness Slayer tasks, this makes getting good tasks much, much easier since you're getting a choice of two tasks instead of one. Now I use these the entire time during Wilderness Slayer, and I personally think they are a must use, and they'll speed up your time and GP per hour significantly. Now to get these, you'll need to either buy them from the Traveling Merchant, buy them with Thaler, or the easiest way, and the way that I got them, was to go to the Gamer's Grotto and play a game of Cabbage Face Bunch Bonanza. Now this game is pretty simple to play, and it only lasts for around 10 minutes per game, and in one game you should get enough points for 5 to 7 tickets. And I'd say from personal experience, for an entire tier 10 emblem, if you play this minigame for around 45 minutes to an hour, you should get around 30 to 40 tickets, and you should be set to go on and get your entire tier 10 emblem and not run out of tickets. It'll definitely save you more than 45 minutes of time, because you don't want to be stuck with tasks that are going to take you super long to do, and trust me, that can happen. Secondly, this is something that I personally didn't have the levels for, as it's really high requirements, but there's no doubt that it's extremely good for Wilderness Slayer, and that is the Slayer Introspection Archaeology Relic, which requires level 119 Archaeology. Now when used, it allows you to choose between the minimum and maximum Slayer assignment amounts. This means if the range for something like Green Dragons to be assigned as a Slayer task were 20 to 50, you can choose to be assigned 20 or 50 Green Dragons. which of course you'd want to choose the 20 green dragons, and it would allow for much faster task completions, and this would be extremely good. So if you have the stats, you should 100% be using this relic for the fastest GP per hour when doing Wilderness Slayer. So now we're gonna look at the gear and inventory setup. Now I want to say that you should 100% be making your own preset, and I'm going to link something below that can help you with that, but I'm gonna give you my gear setup and my inventory so you kind of have something to base yours on. So I will also be linking in the description and at the end of the video a wilderness survival guide. I actually have made a wilderness survival guide showing tons of different tips and tricks and items and different things you can bring with you to help you survive in the wilderness, escape PKers, and just all around not die. I cover things like portents, Phoenix necklaces, abilities, which defensives to use, perks, pretty much everything in that guide. So I'll be linking that in the description and at the end of the video, and you can use that to kind of tailor your preset. But as for my personal preset, what I used was I used Ghost Hunter armor, which basically is dropped from Revenants, so not everyone's gonna have this. You can use something cheap, Mystic, Dehide, depending what style you're using. I was maging, but ranging works well. I also have the Amulet of Glory and Ring of Wealth. They're just cheap rings and amulets. I also have a Zoriel staff. I would bring whatever combat weapon you feel comfortable using. If you feel comfortable bringing a Noxious Staff, bring a Noxious Staff. I have never personally been skull tricked in the wilderness, but I know some people have, so I would caution you to just bring what you're comfortable with, whether that be a Chaotic Staff or a tier 92 staff, whatever you feel the best with. And I also have the Globetrotter boots, which are part of the Clue outfit, which allow you to restore your run. This can be very useful when getting away from PKers, and I cover that as well in the Wilderness Survival Guide that I'll link again in the description. And then I have the Furin 3 bracelet, which obviously protects you from Revenants. As for inventory, I'll go over this super quick. This is my personal inventory. Again, you should make your own depending on what you feel comfortable with. So for me, I bring an old deck coil and cannonballs. This is because if I get different tasks like Hellhounds, Greater Demons, stuff like that, I like to use this. Of course, you don't need to risk cannonballs or anything like that. If you're scared of getting skull tricked, I'm not sure how the old deck coil reacts to other players running by because I've never really had it happen. But for me, I wasn't worried about it. But yeah, it's just something that I bring. I bring, of course, an overload or stat boosting potions. I bring a Fury Shark, which can help you protect an extra item. I bring Phoenix necklaces because, of course, they help heal your health, and if you're attacked, you can put them on and have a little extra safety net. I bring Bruise and Restores, mostly Restores for prayer, and I'd have a Yak as well with food and Restores. The Wilderness Sword 4 is very good for teleports all over the wilderness, and if you're able to get it, I would highly encourage you to unlock the Wilderness Sword 4. I bring a shield because, of course, you need to use a lot of defensives in case of a PK or attack, so it's really, really important to have a shield. And then I have food, and then Portents of Restoration, which are used to automatically heal you if you drop below a certain health. And then, of course, you'll want your Wilderness Emblem. And another few things, you actually cannot yak your Wilderness Emblem, so if you were thinking of trying to yak it if you were attacked by a PKer, that is not possible. So now we're gonna look at all the Slayer tasks and the main strategy. So for the main tasks that I personally did while doing Wilderness Slayer to get as many tasks done as fast as possible were green dragons in priority level 1. They are super fast. You get a low amount of green dragons. You can teleport directly to the Furin 3 dungeon and kill them in 2 to 3 minutes. And they're in lower than level 30 wilderness, so it's relatively easy to teleport away. Now, the second task that I did most often was Revenants. These are a bit more on the risky side, depending if you're in level 30 plus wilderness when killing them, but they're in lower than 30 wild, so you can do them there as well. They're really, really fast to kill, and on top of that, you don't get assigned much, and you have the potential able to drop really good items from them, like the Stadius Warhammer, which goes for around 300 million GP. So for me, I did a ton of these as well. Third was blue dragons, which I did as well. If I didn't get green dragons or revenants, you're assigned a bit more blue dragons than green dragons, and they're in a bit deeper wilderness, but usually it's very dead, and I have never ever seen anyone at blue dragons, so it's not really a hot spot, and they're pretty safe to kill, and they only take a little bit longer to do than revenants or green dragons. Now next, I'm going to talk about the tasks that I would do only if I didn't have enough Slayer points to skip. Keep in mind, my strategy was to use all the Slayer points that I earned from doing Wilderness Slayer as I got them to skip for the fastest task using Slayer VIP tickets. So basically, I used almost all the Slayer points I gained doing this method. Now the two tasks are the Hellhounds and the Greater Demons, which is the main reason why I brought the old deck Coil with me. I would basically go and do these two tasks if I didn't have enough Slayer points to skip, and yeah, that was basically my strategy, was Green Dragons, Revenants, Blue Dragons, and then Hellhounds and Greater Demons. Task I avoided was anything super slow like Gargoyles, Lava Strike Worms, Calgerian Demons. Although these are good money and Slayer XP, they are really deep in the wilderness, pretty unsafe, and they just take a long time to kill, and was just not worth it for what I was trying to do, getting my tier 10 emblem as fast as possible. So you want to make sure you also prioritize not being stuck with a bad Slayer task. For instance, if you only have one Slayer task skip left, and you have a choice between something okay like Hellhounds or Greater Demons, just do these instead of risking being stuck with something like Calgerian Demons or something like that. Now, if you're looking for XP, by all means, you can do the higher level and higher XP task like Lava Strike Worms or Calgerian Demons, and feel free to use something like the Demonic Skull and the Wilderness Slayer contracts for even bigger boosts in XP. So next, you're going to see a graphic with a full breakdown of all the Wildy Slayer tasks based on the speed they take to do. Alright, so that is basically it. That is what you need to know. The Wilderness Survival Guide will be linked at the end of the video and the description, and I just want to follow this up by saying a few more tips. So when you get closer, let's say tier 7, tier 8, tier 9 emblem, dying basically sets you back a lot more. If you die with a tier 4 emblem, it's not going to set you back too much. If you die with a tier 9 emblem, it's going to set you back a lot. So basically, once you get to the higher tier emblems, you may want to play it more safe with tasks. You may want to take tasks that are in a lower level wilderness or not in multi-combat. You may want to bring more food, be extra cautious, hop worlds a lot. Those are just some tips. I would definitely play it a lot safer when I got to a higher tier emblem, and from tier 1 to 6 I didn't really care and kind of just breezed through those as fast as possible. But all in all, Wilderness Slayer is really good, and I think in my last video it took me around 10 hours to get a tier 10 emblem, and I made like 160 mil, which is like 16 million GP per hour. I would say, depending on if you're using the archaeology relic that lets you get less creatures assigned, using Slayer VIP tickets, taking the fastest task possible, basically doing everything you can, I would say this is around 15 to 20 million GP per hour, and it really is a fun and nice change of pace for money making. And also you can get lucky with things like the Stadius Warhammer, and you can make even more money if you do a lot of Revenants. So thanks for watching this Wilderness Slayer guide. I know it was kind of long, but I wanted to pack as much information as I could into this, and make sure to check the description and the end of the video so you can see the Wilderness Survival Guide to make sure you get everything you need to survive in the wilderness. So yeah, make sure to leave a like if this helped you out, guys. Leaving a like definitely helps with the algorithm, so thanks so much. And make sure to subscribe if you want more guides and RuneScape 3 videos like this. Thanks so much, guys, and I'll see you in the next video, and good luck on your Wilderness Slayer.